Every generation has a slew of inventions that change the way we live. Back in the mid-20th century, one of the biggest developments was when plastic started being mass-produced. I mean, think about it. You probably have plastic all over you right now. Your buttons, in your pockets. There's zero doubt that the invention of plastic has certainly been fantastic. And I say that because not too many words rhyme with plastic. In its early years, plastic was created to imitate precious natural materials such as ivory, tortoise shell, and mother of pearl. But with time and chemical modifications, plastic was no longer just an imitation of something else. It became a diverse material in its own right, and a controversial one as well. Clara Deck is senior conservator at the Henry Ford, and she gave me a crash course in Plastics 101.
I use it every single day, and yet I can't tell you what plastic is. What is it?
It's a very complicated question. There are thousands of different kinds of plastics, all based on about 7 different resins that are all polymers. Early plastics were really novelty items. Hair combs were very popular, so small decorative luxury items were generally made out of those early plastics. Plastics got associated with cheap replacements, cheap imitations.
It was ersatz.
Exactly.
The true genesis of plastics as a replacement for precious materials began with the pool ball. A man named John Wesley Hyatt won a contest to create a substitute for ivory pool balls. The substitute was a plastic that Hyatt called celluloid, but yet another type of plastic quickly replaced that.
So I've got some pool balls here.
And what are these made of?
These are actually made of the far superior bakelite.
Is bakelite one of the first plastics?
It is the first truly synthetic plastic.
The range of items made from plastic is seemingly endless. Computers, dolls, patent leather shoes, and more. But as useful as plastics are in everyday life, they also have a dark side, in that many plastics do not degrade. They choke oceans and harm wildlife.
In my profession, I'm a museum conservator. It's my job to save the cultural artifacts, the historic materials that the museum wants to save.
Right.
The world is worried about plastics persisting and never breaking down in nature. I'm worried about plastics that are deteriorating.
The story of plastic begins with animals like elephants hopefully being saved rather than exploited for their natural materials. Then you come here and you think of animals being poisoned by plastic.
Right, right.
Saving wildlife, harming wildlife.
Right.
For conservators like Clara, a first step when encountering a new plastic item is to determine what kind of plastic it is. One of the more basic ways to do that is to do a smell test.
Would you like to smell a plastic?
I would love to smell some plastic.
Plastics degrade, and sometimes when they break down, they give off gases. So what you're smelling right there.
It's a little bit like a stinky cheese.
Yeah, it is.